sample space, set of all possibility outcomes. I will toss. I get head, I should not draw. I get tail, then I should draw a ball. And in the bag, we have 2 red balls and 3 black balls. Either you have to pick defective or non-defective. The outcome will be any one of these. So, 2 possible outcomes. If the number is even, then you should toss the coin only once. And I rolled a die and got an even number. When you get even number, again you should repeat the experiment. That is, die is thrown again. We cannot take 4, 4, 3, 3 because we have only one chip for one time. These are possible outcomes. First one may be 1 and second one may be 2. Welcome to the session, dear students. Today we'll go ahead with the problems of probability. So now, in exercise 16.1, they're asking you, suppose 3 bulbs are selected at random from a lot and each bulb is tested and classified as defective and non-defective. Write the sample space for this experiment. There are 2 types of bulbs and you have to select from that lot and you have to name them defective or non-defective, and you are supposed to select 3 bulbs. So, dear students, so any 3, but there are only 2 possibilities. Either they will be defective or non-defective. So, 2 possibilities are there, and that's why 2 outputs. Either when you take, it may be defective or it may be non-defective, because in the lot of bulbs, only we have 2 types. One is defective, the other one is non-defective. So, whenever you pick, either you have to pick defective or non-defective. The outcome will be any one of these. So, 2 possible outcomes and you have 3 chances. So, 2 cube. What is 2 cube? You are selecting 3. 8 possible outputs. What are the possible outputs? So, I'll take 3 bulbs from a lot. I'll take 1, 2, 3 bulbs. All 3 may be defective. D, D, D. This is 1 possibility. Or only 1 may be defective. Remaining 2 are non-defective. Means D, D, ND. N. So let me assume. So let D stands for defective. They have given, sorry, D is defective, N is non-defective. That is also given. So no need to assume also. D, D, N. Or any one may be defective, means non-defective, means the last one may be non-defective, or second one may be non-defective, or first one may be non-defective. Now, when I take, all 3 may be defective, or when I take 3 bulbs, any one may be defective, last one or second one or first one, or 2 may be non-defective, only 1 may be defective, means DNN or NND, first 2 may be non-defective, or first one non-defective, middle one defective, thus 2D non-defective, or all 3 may be non-defective. So, all possible 8 outcomes I have written, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. What are the possibilities? 3 bulbs I am taking. So, all 3 may be defective, or all 3 may be non-defective, or any 1 may be defective, these 3 possibilities, or any 2 may be defective, these 3 possibilities, any 1 may be defective, these 3 possibilities, total 8. What is meant by sample space? Set of all possible outcomes. I am taking how many bulbs? 1, 2, 3 bulbs. When I take 3 bulbs, in the lot we have only 2 types. One is defective and the other one is non-defective. It should belong to any 1. So, 2 possibilities, 3 outcomes, 2 cube, 8 possible different outcomes. Then a coin is tossed. So you will toss a coin. If the outcome is head, a die is thrown. So you will toss. If you get head, throw a die. So if head comes, throw what? Die. Die is rolled or thrown, whatever. And if the die is thrown, if the die shows even, again if the die is even number, then die is rolled again. If die is even, and again roll die, again die is rolled, then what is the sample space? What is the sample space? See, now I'll toss a sample space, set of all possibility outcomes. I'll toss a coin, I'll get head. First I'll toss a coin. Suppose I'll toss a coin. When you toss a coin, what are the possibilities? You may get head or you may get tail. Say, I got tail. So, I tossed a coin, I got tail. So, I should, that's it. So, because when sample space, when you toss a coin, if you get head, then you should proceed. If you get tail, stop it. Then if you get head, what happens? Suppose if I get head, then I should roll a die. When I roll a die, you may get possible numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. But if it is even number, again you should roll. Suppose I'll roll a die and I'll get 1. 1 means what? Odd number. So I should stop. Or I'll get 3. 3 is odd number. Stop it. Or I'll get 5. 5 is odd number. Stop it. 1, 3, 5 if I get, I should, after rolling a die, I should stop. Suppose I get a head. I got a head. And I rolled a die and got an even number. When you get even number, again you should repeat the experiment. That is, die is thrown again. So then H to 1, after H to 1, or you may get H to 2 or H to 3. So with die, see, when you roll, when you get even number, you should roll a die. And so 3 possibilities, H to 4, H to 5, H to 6. And other even number, similar thing with 4. 4 is also even number. Again, you will roll a die. H41 or H42. H4. So, you can also club them like this. H22, H23, H24, H25, H26. Similarly, so I will roll a die. H4, even number. Again, I will roll a die. 3 or H4. 4 and H4 till 6. Second time when you roll a die, you may get any number, you have to note it. Then when you roll a, when you toss a coin and you roll a die and you get another even number, 6, 6 is even number, again you should roll a die. H61, H62, H63, then H64, H65, H66. These are the possibilities. Got it. Then, okay, we'll go ahead with the question 13. That is, a box contains what? Numbers 1, 2, 3, 4. So, in a slips, they have marked 1, 2, 3, 4. What are the possible outcomes when you draw a slip? You can take 1 and 2. One combination, or you can take 1 with 3, or you can take 1, 4, irrespective of which you are taking first. So they are telling one after the other, 1 with 2, 1 with 3, 1 with 4, or you can take 2 first and 1, and 2, 3 you can take, or 2, 4 you can take, or 3 you will take first and then you will take 1, and 3 with 2 you can take, or 3, 4 you can take. Or you can pick first 1, 4 and 1, then 4, 2, then 4 and 3. These are the possibilities. You cannot take 4, 4, 3, 3 because we have only one slip for one time. These are possible outcomes. First one may be 1 and second one may be 2. Or 1 and 3, or 1 and 4, or 2 and 3, 2 and 4, 2 and like this. Then an experiment consists of rolling a die. First you should roll a die. Then tossing a coin. Then you should toss a coin. Once, okay, time once, that's it. If the number, suppose, if the number on the die is even, the number on the die is even, then you should toss only once. If the number on the die is odd, then you should toss twice. Write the sample space. Simple. So, I'll toss a, sorry, I'll roll a die. Say, I'll get, as they told, I'll get first case, I'll tell. So, they're telling in an experiment what they're doing. First, they'll roll a die. They'll see the number. If the number is even, then you should toss the coin only once. Say, I'll roll a die, I'll get 2. 2 is even number. Then I should toss only once, I'll get 2H. Head I may get, or 2 with tail I may get when you toss a coin. This is one possibility. Or I'll get even number, say 4. 4, then I'll toss a coin, head I'll get, or I may get tail. Or I'll get another even number, say 6, when I roll a die. Again, I'll toss a coin, I may get head or I may get tail. So, 2H2T, 4H4T, 6H6T. This is the case when your die shows even number. Suppose if the number, whatever you are rolled, and if it is odd number, say you got 1, then you should toss the coin twice. Coin is tossed twice. So 1 you will get, and you will toss the coin twice, both you may get hit-head, or 1 head-tail, or 1 with tail-head, or 1 with tail-tail. Or you may get other odd number, say 3, and then you toss twice. When you toss the twice, 3HH, or 3HT, or 3TH, or 3TT. Or you may get, when you roll a die, you may get odd number, say 5. So 5 is odd number. Again, you should toss twice. So when you toss the coin twice, you may get head-head, or head-tail, or you may get tail-head, or you may get tail-tail. So these are the possible outcomes. When you get even number, only toss once. When you get 2, 4, 6, toss the coin once. So 2 with head, 2 with tail you may get. Or 4 with head, 4 with tail you may get. Or 6 with head, 6 with tail you may get. But if you get odd number, you should toss the coin twice. Suppose you get 1, then toss it twice. You may get head, 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 tail, tail, head, tail, tail. And it's the same thing with 3, same thing with 5. Then a coin is tossed. If it shows tail, if it shows what tail? We draw a bulb from a box, and the box contains 2 red bulbs. So box contains 2 red bulbs, R1 and R2, and it also contains 3 black bulbs. 3 black bulbs means B1, B2, B3. Okay. If it shows head, so then find the sample space. So suppose if a coin is tossed, if it shows tails, then the condition exists. If it shows head, stop it. So one output may be head. After head, we should not draw any bulb. So if you get tail, you should draw a bulb. How many bulbs? Draw a bulb. So you may tail with red bulb 1, or tail with red bulb 2, or tail with black bulb 1. That's what happened. And tail with black bulb 2, or tail with black bulb 3. These are the possibilities. Sample space, set of all possibility outcomes. I will toss. I get head, I should not draw. I get tail, then I should draw a ball. And in the bag, we have 2 red balls and 3 black balls. So after tail, I may get first red ball. After tail, I'll draw second red ball or first black. Or these are the possibilities. A die is thrown repeatedly until a 6 comes up. So roll the die. If you get 6, stop it. If you don't get 6, continue. Suppose sample space. It's an infinite sample space. A big sample space, because a lot of possibilities. So in this sample space, I'll get 1 in the first shot. Then again I'll roll a die. Again I may get 1. And then I should continue. 1 with 1, 1 with 2 I may get. 1, 2, 1, 3. See, when you get 1 and if you get 2, you should not stop the process. So process continue. Suppose in first throw if you get 6, stop it. 6 is one outcome. Suppose if you get 1, then you roll a die. If you get 6, stop it. Suppose you roll first time you get 2, then again second time if you get 6, stop it. 3, 6, stop it. First time I'll roll, I'll get 3. Then you have to repeatedly, you have to repeat it until you get a 6. Suppose first time I'll get 4, then you throw, if you get 6, stop it. Or first time I get 5, then you throw, if you get 6, stop it. First time if I roll and if I get 6, I'll stop it. Because that's what I've done here. So, no. Next, first time if I roll, if I get 6, stop it. Then I'll suppose I may get first time 1, second time also 1, then I should continue until I get 6. Then 1, I'll roll second time. If I get 2, first time I'll roll the die, say I got 2, then I'll roll the die. Again, I'll not get, I'll get say 1. Then I'll roll, I'll get 6, stop it. Or 2, 2, 6, stop it. 2, 2, then start with 3. Like that, or 2, 3 and 6, stop it. 2, first roll, second roll is 4. Then you have chance to third roll, it goes on. It goes on. Suppose 3 I got, again 3 I got, again I get 1. So till I get 6. So this is an infinite sample space. One of the good questions. So I hope all of you understood. So now we have done sample space. Please sit and revise this. I'll see you in my next session. Thanks for attending. Thank you.